All right, all. This is Dr. Alsup, and our next type of joint that we're going to discuss are the cartilaginous joints. So similar to the fibrous joint video, here we will discuss what cartilaginous joints are made of, and then we're going to discuss where we can actually locate them on the body. So, cartilaginous joints are joints in which the connective tissue that connects the bones is cartilage, as its name would suggest. And these are solid masses or solid blocks of cartilage which are located right in between the bones and what is actually connecting them. We will see with synovial joints that there is articular or hyaline cartilage associated with the synovial joints, but that is not what is actually connecting the bone. So that's the big difference between that part of cartilage on a synovial joint and the cartilaginous joints, which have the solid mass in between. And instead of the three types like we had with the fibrous joints, there are only two categories of cartilaginous joints. So let's talk about each one. The first one we're going to discuss is the synchondrosis, which has bones that are being connected by a solid sheet of hyaline cartilage. Now, don't confuse this with a syndesmosis, even though they sound pretty similar, but this particular joint has the chondra in the name, and we know that that means cartilage is involved. Synchondroses are immovable, and many of these are actually what we refer to as temporary. So, in the cases of epiphyseal plates, these are going to be temporary cartilaginous joints. So remember, with the epiphyseal plate, you're going to have the epiphysis, you'll have part of the diaphysis being connected by this hyaline cartilage, referred to as the epiphyseal plate. Eventually, this cartilage will actually grow and then be replaced by bone and eventually be completely replaced with bone. And then these become those bony joints referred to as synostoses. But not all synchondroses are temporary, like in the case of the joint between the top part of the sternum, or the manubrium, and the first rib. This is also an example of a synchondrosis, but it's not temporary. It will stay a synchondrosis throughout life. Okay, so that's a synchondrosis, and moving right along, let's talk symphyses, if you're talking about multiple, and symphysis, if you're talking about the singular. A symphysis is a little more complex. So the ends of the bones are going to have a layer of hyaline cartilage, but the bones are actually connected by a broad, sometimes flat disc of fibrocartilage. So usually the part of the cartilage that you can see is going to be the fibrocartilage. There are some exceptions to this rule, but since most fall within this, let's go with that definition there. Something neat about symphyses is that they are all found along the midline. So like right down that longitudinal axis. So you can see here the pubic symphysis, which has symphysis right in its name. This is right in the midline. The midline would be right in this region here. We know that because the sacrum is part of that vertebral column, which is going down the midline. So it's going to be part of that anterior portion of the pelvic region, but in the midline, as well as intervertebral discs, which we're looking at a lateral view here, so you can't quite tell if that's in the midline. But all those bodies of the vertebrae are going to be running down the midline, and the intervertebral disc is going to be in between those bodies, and this is an example of a symphysis. All right, so those are the cartilaginous joints. Let's assess your knowledge on one of these concepts. So question, the epiphyseal plate is an example of which type of cartilaginous joint? Is it A, symphysis, B, synchondrosis, or C, synostosis? So what do you think? An epiphyseal plate, remember, is only present in a growing bone between an epiphysis and a diaphysis. And key here, it has not been completely replaced with bone, like you would have in a synostosis. So synostosis, or C, is incorrect. Symphysis isn't correct either, because they tend to be slightly movable. They're only located in the midline, and epiphyseal plates are not going to be that. So that leaves synchondrosis as the correct answer, and it is. I hope that question felt comfortable to you. But if not, don't fret. You now know this is an area you need to review a bit more, and that is valuable information. If you got it correct, then no sweat. Then you likely don't need to spend quite as much time of your valuable studying time on something that you're already pretty comfortable with. So even when you miss questions, it gives you an idea that that's an area you want to spend a little bit more time studying on. Whereas if you get it right without thinking too hard, then it's likely something you have down and you can kind of move on. All right, so great work. Keep it up, and I will see you in the next video.